I just wanted to, Tom, I might just pick up on that point very quickly, because Jackie had a good answer to that. I just want to add a little bit to it. A number of the decisions that have been taken in relation to the Queen Victoria Market proposed redevelopment have been done in confidential sessions. What that means is that once the confidential discussion is open, and even when it is resolved and a decision is taken, every council subject to that meeting, in fact every council, whether they're at the meeting or not, is bound by that confidentiality. Even when we're subject to fines that can run into tens of thousands of dollars, we're going to be sat together. And Jackie is dead right, and I don't use the word threat. We are threatened constantly with the penalties of breaching that act and for breaching confidentiality. So we are bound with our penalty and frustrated the hell out of us. So that, let me tell you. Frustrated the hell out of us because there is that much that we want to say to you. So I just want to pick up on that because you deserve an answer. I wanted to, though, before I get started, I wanted to just pass on my hands because I think I can speak for everyone here, for every person on the panel tonight. We're all here for the right reasons. We're all here because we're in support of you. And I especially wanted to make mention of the union movement because the union movement has got motivated behind this. Hatteria and her colleagues have been absolutely wonderful. They've been nothing. So I want to be able to give gratitude to the union movement and indeed to the other speakers here tonight. One thing that I wanted to pick up on, Kevin made a really good point earlier about we discussed what councillors can do about disasters, redevelopment like this or what is proposed anyway. And I wanted to make mention of what Jackie and I have tried to do, the implementation plan that was put up just a couple of weeks ago. We did attempt to defer that because I agree with Kevin, I agree with a number of other people. This as well. This should be an aid for the new council. We should put this to the community and allow them to vote on it. We tried to defer it in order that may happen and that is defeated. So these are the things that you can try to do, but again, if there are not six hands in the air, you're not going to get it. So it's not from lack of trying. One thing that I wanted to say about that too is the sorts of things that we do deal with when we talk to the community and then we try to talk to other councillors and we raise this in meetings. One thing that I'm always talking about, and I know I mentioned this recently in the trades hall too, so for those of you who were there to begin with, the same is again. But when I talk to small business people, especially traders at the Queen Victoria Market, I haven't met one yet that doesn't want to make a dollar. I mean, everybody's pretty keen on doing good business, and they do that pretty well at the Queen Victoria Market. You guys do it pretty well because you know your customers, you know the community, you know what they want. So don't you think that if there was a dollar in this, people would be behind the redevelopment? If it was a good thing, if it was good for traders and good for the community, don't you think meetings like this would be talking about how great it is? You just don't hear that. You don't hear that. We don't hear that any messages coming through consultations either. We raise this question about how they're briefed. And we're getting feedback from consultations, but somehow it's overwhelmingly positive all the time. You come to meetings like this, well, let me tell you, it's a very different message that we're getting. Don't worry, to everybody here, it's coming through loud and clear. We're hearing it. And that's why we're here speaking with you tonight. We're just continuing to listen. I won't speak for every councillor, but I'm completely trusting of the feedback we get on consultations, that's for sure. So that brings me to Robert Boyle. And I think Phil made a very, very good point earlier. There is one sure way to stop this thing, and that is to vote Robert Boyle out. You've got elections. Election in less than 3 months. You all need to be mindful of that. There's an election in less than 3 months. If you are not enrolled to vote in that election, you have until the 26th of August, so get on with it. There's only a couple of weeks in it. Check your enrolment and make sure you can have your say. When you're so passionate about this, don't let the opportunity slip through your fingers. Don't let the opportunity to let Robert Boyle know just how passionate you are and how important it is to stop this thing slip through your fingers. Make sure you have your say. It's the 26th of August, okay? The enrolment closes 26th of August. So make sure that you're on to that. The evidence is in, though, and again, I'll refer to the consultation. The evidence is in that Robert Boyle needs the markets for voters. Robert Doyle thinks the market's for poor people or something, and somehow it's not important to anybody else. And even if it was the vote, it's poor people. So what's the problem with that? I've yet to see any problem with that. What we do know is that he cares a lot about developers. We know that because of how many of them donated to his last campaign. Now, we all know that. The community needs to hear more of that too. So when you're talking to your friends and family, when you're thinking about the next election coming up, just remember where the motivation is. He's bagged out the community that likes the market. He's bagged out the community that supports the market and the traders. He might bag out the developers. Now, he's good friends with the developers. Again, we know that from the donations he receives from them. At the end of the day, we know that all this amounts to, when it comes to the development that has very good support, all this amounts to is some sort of fast-accruing, superannuated farce for Robert Doyle and his mates. And that's what has to be stopped. We as a community can get together as we are tonight, and we can stop that. But we have to keep going. As Phil said, we have to keep going. This is a work in progress. We need your support. We need you to get behind the councillors and the candidates for the next election that will oppose this development, continue to oppose the development, because until there's a majority of six hands in the air, we can't guarantee that it will be stopped.